is the core.
A fantastic day it is right here. And yes, guys, you're on to your number one urban breakfast show, The Core, with your fantastic host. My name is Fay.
And I am Dakel.
Definitely. I hope you guys are getting your game on already. Definitely, guys, you know what we do on The Core. We talk about topical issues that affect you and I in our everyday lives.
Definitely.
Whatever it is, we dissect and break it down on the set.
Yes, definitely. And we have different segments.
Different segments.
We have the paper talk segment. We have the magnet game show. We have the cookie jar. We have the paper talk. I already mentioned that. Definitely a whole lot more coming your way that you don't never want to miss.
Trust me, never want to miss it, guys. And definitely today, let's just go on to the topic of today's discourse. We're talking dance as a profession. So guys, we'll go on a break, and then when we return, The Core continues. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back. This is The Core. All right, guys, so right now we're going to be taking a look at the stories making the headlines in our newspapers. Yep. And yes, we're going to start from the Punch newspaper.
All right, you start with me, yeah?
Yes, that's
right. That's me. Whistleblower exposes 4 billion naira in secret accounts and suspect flees. Ileife, 21 arrested indigents, sues IG and demands 1 billion naira. Russian fighters jet arrive and military plans fresh bombing of Lagos creeks. Our officials collected 3 billion naira bribes to rig 2015 polls. That's INEC. Commission suspends 205 officials and refers 70 to the EFCC and send names of ex-commissioner 5 RECS to EFCC Buhari. And El-Rufai releases Kaduna security budget, not security votes. That was said by Dogara. And Malabo, some people threatened by my rising international profile, says Jonathan. I'll take that again. Some people threatened by my rising international profile, says Jonathan. That's said by Malabo. And also we have Queen's College deaths. Reps summons 2 ministers and principals. You failed your people, Sanusi attacks Zamfara governor again. Power generation sinks to 108 megawatts. That's all we have on the Punch headlines.
Pretty
this
interesting one today, I must say. So, guys, on to the Daily Sun, we have 3 shots fired in late Navy Admiral's room, and that's by the police. Say no hiding place for Army Captain Policeman's killers. And 2015 elections, INEC exposes 3 billion naira bribe. Naira slumps to 410 naira in parallel market. And fire got fan administrative building. EFCC uncovers 4 billion naira in Niger suspect flee. Chibok girls Cardinal Onayeko, chief imam, join protest march in Abuja. And Dokara tackles El-Rufai, calls Kaduna governor meddlesome interloper. And reps consider inviting Jonathan over Malabo probe, recommend Deziani's Adoke's trial. And that's what we have on the front page today on the Daily Sun.
All right, guys, this is a complete sport. I'm just going to read the sport making headlines on the paper this morning. All right, so we have Juve blows Barca away, like blows them away. 3-0, Juventus won Barcelona yesterday, 3-0. That was insane and incredible at the same time. Shout out to all Barca fans. And Master versus Pupil. Zidane ready to turn Ancelotti's lessons upon his old master in Bayern Madrid clash. And we also have Verratti wants Neymar at PSG. Emenike desperate for England return. He tells agent he wants to play in the EPL. And Musa says, we don't fear Atletico. The City striker targets semi-final ticket. And we also have Real Madrid confident of luring Hazard to Bernabeu. I don't see that happening. Hazard is at Chelsea, Hazard is blue, and Hazard is not going anywhere. Dortmund match postponed after explosion. I didn't see the game yesterday, but that's, anyway, that's all we have on the papers making the headlines this morning, okay?
All right, guys, so on to entertainment. Women have to learn to stand for each other. If not, a lot of my fellow men will never allow you all go far. And that's by Uti Nwachukwu as he reacts to Ruben Abati's BBNaija article. And Pastor Nike Adeyemi stuns in new photos as she celebrates her 50th birthday, which was yesterday. And to Baba, DJ Jimmy Jad, Jumoke Orisa Gunna, and more at the exclusive media event to unveil Royal Highness a mega mix of the iconic True Baba songs. And one thing I also saw here, Caitlyn Jenner reveals she has had a gender reassignment surgery in new memo, The Secret of My Life.
Right.
Yes, and another one, what's his name? Ed Sheeran pays copyright. Apparently the song Photograph
was
a copyright, so he's paid for the lawsuit and all that.
Who did that's he copy this time? No, I think it was I can't remember the person, but
the person, he definitely copied someone. But it's good with like his face. Some people here just copy and nobody even gets their ad.
And the fact that he actually did justice to the copy. So it was a rightly copied copyright.
Shout out to Ed Sheeran, you copied it right with us. Guys, we go on another break. And when we return, the trills, the turns, and everything you can think about continues right here on the call. We'll be right back. One.
Him dancing, like Kevin, he's a good dancer, so he's an international dancer, so I believe he's a working for everybody who shoots as a character work. You know, because I like the child, that's what the father was doing, your experience. That way, have your way of living. And
at number five, my top five swallowed meal is I just pick Semovita.
How did you pick? But you say you don't like swallows, but you still picked it because you will eat it if they give it to you. Guys, my top five for the first time in agreement is Semovita.
For swallow meal, I just take wheat. I like wheat.
And my top four people is wheat too.
Number one, top five swallow meals in Nigeria. Amala.
I knew it was going to hit.
Ogbono fairly Amala.
Hi guys, you're welcome to Say Five on Delaru TV. My name is Fola.
And I am D to the A to the K to the E to the
To the L. Off Young Edit and Tony, aka Thin Tall Tony Hills from Cross River State. The 36-year-old is a professional dance artist with 18 years experience. TTT is also an OAP on 99.3 Nigeria Info FM. In 2005, TTT was funded by UNESCO to Austria at Dance Web 2005. He has performed at various places, including MTN Project Fame opening ceremony in 2009, semi-finalist Apex on Mnet's Let's Dance Nigeria 2009 edition, and anchor for Okpa Williams' National Comedy Challenge show in 2010. TTT came to limelight on the Big Brother Niger show 2017. He was on the show for 56 days before his eviction. TTT is married with two kids. Ladies and gentlemen, Thin Tall Tony.
This is The Core.
All right, guys, so we have the perfect gentleman, the perfect Thin Tall Tony.
I think she's taking away the thin away from me now because I'm not seeing anything anymore. Because everything, I see the belly, I see the arms. This is no longer thin.
Ready to get it now. All right, guys. So we have the perfect man to talk about dance as a profession. Definitely. Yeah. So she said you started 1998.
Professionally, and all that.
So let's take it to, you started in 1998. When you started dancing in Nigeria, you started in Nigeria?
Yes, I did.
In Nigeria. Now,
at the National Theatre.
What has the dance growth in Nigeria been like? From where you started, as your rotation changed and more people coming into dancing?
Yes, definitely. There's a whole lot of people, individuals.
Positive change?
Yes. Yeah, positive changes. Mm. You know, in terms of the art itself.
Okay.
You know, the one problem that's always been there right from the day I came in, and
maybe after I leave, will still be finance funding.
Right.
You know, so most of us will try as much as we can to change that.
Yeah.
For the time being. But the growth has been amazing. Yeah. You know, most times then between 98 and 2003.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I started touring in 2004. So touring. From that time, it was always, if you really want to know anything about dance, you have to leave the country. You have to go for workshops. You have to, and that's what a lot of people don't do now, or rather a lot of dancers don't do. Yes. It's a good thing that there's social media and you can, you know, watch things. But the experience physically is also very engaging, very important that you do that. Most people always run away when you hear seminars or workshop, even here. And we try as much as we can to even bring some of them notable choreographers, you know, motivational speakers.
But when you say most people try to run away, now, is there always an awareness created when you want to do those workshops?
There is. Very strong awareness. Like, very strong everybody publicity. Gets to know about
it. See, I'm not blaming anybody, auntie. Because, really.
Yeah, switch, man. You
see that they pay me. But the truth is, why would I come? I'm just speaking from a layman's point of view.
Right.
Why would I come for your workshop?
Okay.
Where I have some dance or some activity somewhere or a class somewhere to teach. Where go pay me 10k.
Yeah.
I can't come. I go there for maybe 2 hours, they give me 10k. I can't come your workshop or your seminar for 4 hours and you just want to teach me and you know they put anything in my pocket. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So everybody is looking for a way to hustle. A dancer in this country, really, let me tell you what the timetable is like.
Okay.
Yeah.
From September to first week of January, there is something happening.
True.
Awards, events,
concerts and all that.
Musicals. Yeah. Now we have musicals.
Mm.
Then maybe February 14th, something comes up. Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But from March till beginning of September, that timetable is
droughts, right?
Empty.
Mm. Mm.
Okay. So, and every single dancer is trying to look for a way to hustle.
Right.
Yeah.
And you have to have workshop in between.
Yeah.
And you know they give me food job. You need to put accounts. Right. You need to put money for my account. Right. He expects our cost.
I see the logic now.
So each time we have this, it's always good when we have like my colleagues come around for them workshops. It's great.
Mm.
But we do this workshop so that every other person can be part of it.
True.
Now, within that time phrase, we have like reality shows that come from Nigerian breweries. We've got other people doing you know, shows here and there.
Yep.
Anything that there's money, will we go for it?
All right.
But when the workshop that's to the
money is the drive, right?
The even the workshop that would, you know, build your mind.
Yeah.
Because you don't have that opportunity to travel out.
Mm.
Yeah.
So we most of us, when we go, we learn, we take that back.
I mean,
we have a workshop.
You've traveled like a bit, like around.
Yeah.
A bit. I've traveled around a lot.
He had to just say that. Like
you had to just
where
say,
have you done your dance stuff?
I haven't been to Asia and I have not been to America. But every other place I have touched.
Oh,
that's huge, man. That's huge. All right, do we still get more? All right, so I'm going to ask you a question. Like, from that time you started dancing professionally to right now, what are the different dances we have actually inculcated that we have started as Nigerians that weren't there before that are really in existence right now?
Well, the great part is that we keep inventing new things every day. And then the eye of the world is tuned to Africa.
Yes.
Not just Nigeria, but funny enough, we're very loud than every other African country. No offense to any other person, but it's just true. Because before you know, there's one new dance here, there's one new dance there, there's somebody creating a dance. What's his name? MC Galaxy did Sekem. It's everywhere. P Square did
Alingo.
Yeah. They brought Azunto.
Then we
up our game. Say, no, now I won't be this. And then, funny enough, now I won't end everywhere.
You know,
because
it
also goes also with the music.
Yeah.
You know, so there's a whole lot from Galala to Alanta.
And see how we even brought Makossa into it.
Yeah.
You never danced Makossa.
Even the dabs, we coined it in a sort of way, like there's something called the Nigerian dab now. Looking at
you know,
most
so
of our artists.
Everybody's coming up with new styles every single day.
Right.
I've got my style.
What about you?
What's your style
coming up? When is your style going to go viral?
What style do you have now?
Well, you would see my style on stage.
Okay.
We anticipate the stages.
When I was talking about dance steps, I know that some people say certain dance steps mean certain things. I don't know if that's true. There's a symbolism to some certain dance steps. Now, can you throw more light on that?
Sounds a bit creepy.
Yeah.
Which?
Like, you could just talk about
the culture behind the dance.
Yeah, a certain dance step that has to do with a certain culture. What does resonates with that sort of dance? Let me see.
I'll take farmer's dance, for example.
Farmer's dance.
Like a Shosho dance that we have in Nigeria.
Okay.
It's the basic things that we do when we go to the farm. We hoe, we plant, we harvest.
Okay.
And then we were able to bring all of that
into
like
dance.
a full scene to see how we do it until when we obviously you would not see
the
crop grow.
Yeah.
So there's most of those Shosho dances like that, the farmer's dance, fisherman dance, there's another.
That's when you mentioned before. Now you said what's Yoruba?
The bata.
The bata. No.
But all of that came from you know Shanguna.
Yes.
That one too. It's very thunderous, man.
Right.
You know?
Right.
But as much as we've got those places in the western part of Nigeria, every single bata, there's always a slight difference.
We've actually incorporated other Western dance steps into ours, cha-cha-cha and all that.
Yeah.
Now, how do you, as a dancer, or for you to be called a good dancer, if you're a Nigerian, do you have to merge these Western dance steps? Is that what makes you an overall good dancer?
Yeah.
Do you need to incorporate these Western dance steps to our Nigerian dance steps for you to sell, or for people to key into what you're selling to
them? Nowadays, everybody wants to commercialize everything, you know. Me learning these things is because I wanted to be in the frame that I am in my dance career,
right?
To be able to use that. If I do that, like the rule in contemporary is there are no rules.
Rules in contemporary.
There are no rules.
Break your bones,
but if you want to
whatever.
Be like a hip hop dancer, for example, then you have to decide: do you want to be a pop and lock dancer? Do you want to do break dancing? Do you want to be a lyrical dancer? You allow the words, or rather you dance to the words.
To the words.
Okay.
That's the first I'm hearing of it.
Sounds very deep.
Yeah.
Sounds
like, so when you're talking to
it's not the same thing as miming or choreography?
It's a blend between mime and dance. So it's not like you're just there telling the girl.
Can you do that again?
Mine,
no, I didn't get it.
Okay, that's you wanting
Guy.
To fight now.
Guy.
Right.
I think it's just you.
Okay.
Just go on.
Okay, so right. So like I said, so you have to now decide.
Okay.
And those ones, they come with rules.
Mm.
You know, you can blend them, but there are some people who do like Latin dances, for example.
Yeah.
You want to be a professional salsa dancer or cha-cha dancer or a rumba dancer, and all of these have like different sway to it and different rhythm to it,
different traditions.
So you don't necessarily have to know everything.
Right.
Know the one that you want to be focused on,
mm-hmm.
and do it well. Don't just do half. You know, like today now you say, I'm a dance instructor.
Yeah.
Yes,
tissue
sir.
Salsa. Tissue first two step, show you how to turn. Before you know it, don't they spin the gear? Even you, the way they spin that, you break the gear hand. Then you can't complain. Say, what's your problem? You can't even relax. That's your problem. You have both turned now.
Have you been that person? It sounds like it's been that person before.
Yes.
No, I haven't.
Are you sure?
I haven't.
Guys, we need to check you. I'm telling you, we need to check you. Guys, we'll go on another break.
Right.
Trust me. I hope you guys are having fun. You
know,
dance as a profession with Theme Tall Tony, Dakel, and I are still here. We're still going to be here when we go on this break and we return. It continues, as I always say. Keep your eyes glued to your devices. We'll be right back.
Drink with the core.
This is The Core.
This is The Core.
All right, guys. So right now we're moving on to the Magnet Game Show.
Oh, right.
Ha, games.
Yes, sir.
Games.
Not really. BS. No. We were, I'm talking about, you know, intellectual.
Look at his hand. You know he plays
yeah,
a lot of games.
Yeah, he's already doing that. I'm telling you.
I didn't miss the thing.
So Magnet Game Show, basically, we ask you a word, and the first word that comes to your mind that attracts you to that word I ask is what you see. So you have 3 seconds. Yep. If I say, like, glasses, what comes to your mind?
No time for
glasses now. Afoju,
oh, okay.
Really?
Okay.
Yeah, or you can say cup. You can say tea.
Mm. Ah,
you know,
yeah,
something like that.
Yeah, that kind of thing. Yeah.
So glasses, you can say eyes.
Eyes. Yeah. No. Just okay. Like that.
So you got 3 seconds.
So I'm the main timekeeper. I'm the main clock.
So you say so you end up doing
something like that. You know, like.
So we're ready. On. I'm ready.
You know,
let's try.
Okay. So this. In 3, 2, 1, in action. Infidelity.
You have to talk.
Me.
Yes.
You.
Yes.
Okay. 3 seconds. Marriage.
Army.
Muscles.
Bassy.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
Kemen.
Cougar.
Okay. Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
Blue balls.
T-boss.
T-boss. That's actually my next question. T-boss.
Clean.
Big brother.
Strange.
Celibate.
Yeah. Don't even say you, man.
Celibate.
Oh,
STD. You have to provide an answer, dude.
Quick, fast, and in a hurry. 3 seconds.
STD.
Friends.
Condoms.
Me.
Sex.
Me.
Blowjob.
What's going on?
Say something.
Wifey.
Wifey.
Dance.
DGN.
Nipple piercings.
T-boss.
Tattoos.
T-boss.
All right.
Fabrisky.
Amazing.
Okay.
Male strippers.
Intelligent.
One night stand.
Keep it coming.
All right, guys, we're done.
Wow.
That's
what
happened? He honked.
Yeah, really did. What happened at the blowjob? You're like,
yeah, he did like
what's going on?
Like,
what? Okay. Wow, sir. You never saw that coming, right?
No.
All right, guys, okay. We have to go on another break. Trust me, you have to anticipate more. He's bringing some hard things to us. We're getting some hard things to him also. Wow. That sounds right.
It's coming.
But yeah, we're going on a break, and when we return, we
continue. I was deceived.
This is The Core.
People in dancing, like Kevin, is a good dancer, so he's an international dancer, so I... It's a working for everybody who shoots as a character. You know, before they like the child, that's what the father was, your experience. That way, have your way of living. And
you start flipping this out, and you flip that out, and you flip the other thing out. Ah, what's going on here? And then, first he sees a tools, and then he ends up seeing a Bob Risky. Like, what the?
I really don't get why a guy would fall in love with another guy.
I am putting on both parts. So if he touches me, and then he feels it, he won't be too shocked.
Am I mad? When they are strong, tall, dark guys with body frame, and I start admiring BC for crying out loud.
Funny enough, you know, I've actually done that before.
Oh my God, so now me get this guy. I'm going to tie him like this to myself.
It's time for my top, yeah.
This is The Core.
The show.
Yeah. We're not doing it boy again.
Tell me that. We're back to the core. This is the core.
I'm also talking about the amount I'm going to pay for dancing classes.
Yeah.
Yes, so 500 now per month. Stop take bites. It for living.
Per month?
Yes, so.
Oh, boy. Where that from? You don't know school fees, dude.
Yeah, right? So, yeah, we're talking about dance. Let's go back to dance. Now, you're a dancer. What do you think has been your best performance, or what has been your worst performance in terms of dancing since you started?
I mean, you can't tell me you've never had a worst.
Well, obviously we have our moments, but the power to be able to improvise has helped us to understand that there is really no bad or good moments.
Okay.
The only thing that really makes my spirit jump is after my performance and I see the audience to stand up and they give me a round of applause. That's my fulfillment,
right?
You know, the worst part is when I when I did a show and I did as low as 500 naira for tickets.
Wow.
Nobody showed.
Wow. Oh my goodness.
So I ended up saying, see me the wrong for
it's free.
I was like, it's free, it's free. And then the hall was filled.
Oh, you had to
look for money somehow, give to the guys and say, you know, but that's
like a while ago, right?
That's passion though, because trust me, around the people, you don't even show up. That was just damping your spirit.
That just
kills your dream.
Exactly.
So, yeah, that's like, thank
you.
But
look at you right now. Look at you. It's TTT right now. Everybody knows it.
Everybody knows
it. He's even about to charge us 500k for 1 month.
I'm telling you.
I just said 500k. I never said 1 month.
How much was that for a year?
For 2 years.
No, just to listen to you guys.
I'm joking. Okay, so we're talking musical videos. We're talking about that last night.
Yeah.
Now we have lots of video vixens and the likes now. I stand to be corrected. I stand not to be corrected. I know they are hardly celebrated. There's this is it tag on video vixens?
On vixens, like, dancers.
They are low life persons. Yeah. I've heard such things and all that.
Yeah.
Now, you as a brand, you're a professional dancer.
That's a big brand, actually.
You have things you want to put in place. Do you have any sort of plans to curb those type of tags
to
video vixens? How do you want to elevate the art of dancing?
Because really, it's really terrible. Videos. They see dancers like, it's a dancer.
Which is true, actually. You know, this is where the word greed comes into play.
Okay, who's greedy here?
Us.
Who's us?
We as dancers, we are greedy.
Oh.
Because when we have that opportunity to work with maybe an artist, they tell you how much it is, and say they tell you 5 naira, and bring 10 people to work with.
Yeah.
I'm telling my own people that we are hustling together, that I'm paying you 2 naira.
Yeah.
So I get to eat out of your own sweat, and we are in the same hustle together. It really doesn't make sense to me.
All right. So you think like this artist actually do justice, the payment, the fees they pay?
Well, most of them have no idea that most of these things are happening, because you don't even have people that even negotiate. I know that I've gone to someone's office before, and I negotiated for 50 dancers.
Yeah.
And when I gave them the amount, they go like, "Ah, it's too much. Help us and reduce it." And I did. And then later they go like, "The money that you're even telling us is the money for the whole production." And I'm like, "Then don't do it.
Don't do it, yeah.
You know, do not do it. When you are ready, if you think I should do it, I'll do it." But there's always one person that always goes behind to take it.
Always a bad egg.
Have you been that person before?
Never.
Seriously?
Oh my God.
TTT.
I'm serious.
Be honest.
That is shame, man.
I have people who would get up and say, "This guy, if you not do right, I not do one." So instead of doing that, that's why I started creating my own. I have my own production, 3 productions that I'm dusting up, and I want to put on Terra Culture very soon. I tried to have a meeting with her yesterday, but she was a bit busy, but I will still go back again, you know.
So that's like some dance academy or something?
That's like some big contemporary thing. So you have to. But definitely once that comes up, you guys will definitely have a complimentary. Just come and see. So you have something to talk about.
Shout out to TTT.
We're about
to promote, like, you know, dance, promote the craft. Oh, so definitely.
You should.
Yeah.
Because this is the least talked about part of the arts, or not respected part of the arts.
And we're evolving. We're evolving with the new age. We're evolving with the world now.
You have to take in not dances. Yeah.
You as a musician and you are on stage and you're dancing, you're adding color with dance and people, and you don't pay them right. That's why I doff my hat to Banky. I doff my hat to P Square. Okay. I doff my hat to Two Face.
Okay.
You know, MI. Because whether I like it or not, I have friends who have worked with them indirectly, and they come back to say, "Oh, Bob, man, then treat us well." Yeah. Then the welfare of the artist. Don't just look at them like because they don't need to not dance. They're just there, you know. They are also human beings. Sometimes they also have to get out of their own shell to teach you the artist a few steps so that you can flow with them.
Yeah,
you know. But I'm also not in support of ladies who dance for musicians and go shake bum. I've been saying that in the house.
Oh, really?
Why aren't you in support of it?
Well, because, you know, when you watch some other musical video, you've seen the Justin Bieber, did they shake ass or not? They did.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did they shake it well? They did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did they shake it in a way that is appealing? They did.
They did. Right.
But when we have ladies here who just go on stage and just shake ass and guys are grabbing, it doesn't make sense, because once they're done and they want to go home, they get harassed,
they get
because you've sent a wrong message across. You know, we're very excited when we see people dance, and they're very much excited when the girls are wearing skimpy clothes and make the ass like twerk and all of that.
Yeah.
And they were like, "Hey, Jesus." And then when the girl is going home, you are going there to meet
her.
There is no line. There is no difference to say, okay, when she was on stage, she was walking. Now she's going home.
But
she's,
you know, just to add to that, don't you think that's what the Nigerian market wants?
You know.
No.
People like to see stuff, just sit on your TV and like,
selling what people want to watch. Like, they want a girl who is shaking her bum, who has some skimpy things on.
I agree, but you know, like they say, sex sells, but sex packaged properly.
Right.
You know, it's not
packaging,
like,
is the word.
Yeah. Yes. So don't just come on stage. Haven't you seen some videos or some concerts or where the guy is singing and the girls are looking at himself like, "Hey, so what's with the next thing?" You never see him before.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm like,
definitely.
Why dance for it when you're not sure
what you're doing? Right?
Because even apart from that, that's also enough reason for that person to go like, "They're just normal dancers, so I can approach them anyway." But you don't see all the other ones like that. Mm-hmm. No, you don't shake ass where I am.
People actually think that not everybody can dance.
Everyone can dance.
I was going to ask, like, is it actually true? Because you see some people dance, I'm like, really?
Or do we say, are they good dancers or are they bad dancers?
Yes.
Maybe that's the word.
No, everyone can dance and everyone's got a rhythm, their own kind of rhythm, you know. But you just have to, you have to just look for it. Yeah. Like sometimes when I do my own contemporary piece, my music is this way, my dance is this way.
All right.
You know, it doesn't have to sync.
So you think everybody can actually dance?
Everyone, not can, everyone is a dancer.
Everyone is a dancer.
Yes.
Who is a good dancer? Who is a bad dancer?
Well, if you want to say a bad dancer is the ones that doesn't take instructions.
Okay.
The bad dancers are the ones that follows the choreography, goes on stage, and just wants to overshine more than the choreography.
Okay.
Those are bad dancers.
Now, don't you think some people have more flexibility, more steps than other people?
That's also
that,
to
that actually
advantage.
Makes other people bad dancers.
No.
That
is to your advantage. You being flexible.
Yeah.
But where it becomes a problem is, say for example, want to do a bata dance and you are too flexible. We don't need flexibility in bata dance.
Okay.
We just need you to do bata dance. So you don't go there and start doing like this. And it's like, who asked you? Who sent you? Now that, at that moment, you're a bad dancer.
Okay, I like the definition.
Okay,
though.
But apart from that, even coming to a regular dancing,
yeah.
I know if you go to a club or something, how do you spot someone who is a very good dancer? Now, it doesn't mean the person is not taking instructions there, but how do you spot a good dancer? Then
after the consumption of alcohol and everything,
the
system,
spot a bad dancer. He's probably not going to the rhythm of that song. He's missing some steps.
Like you were doing in the house, sometimes on Saturday, I see TTT doing some dance, my mom be like,
started.
He's drunk. You know. So what used to happen during those times, man? Was it intentional or something?
I, I'm more like the happening guy. I like that the place is pumping. How can I have like such an amazing DJ when you Google and then you hear how much they pay them for the show. And you have that guy play for you and you don't dance. You're not appreciating him. You're not appreciating the music.
All right, guys, you've heard it. Yeah, he definitely appreciates the art of dancing. And whether I was drunk when it was back in the dirty, shall dance and we're entertained.
So I was always dancing.
So guys, go on a break, and when we return, it continues. The thrills, the turns, or whatever you can think of continues right here on The Call with TTT and Dakel and Fay. We'll be right back. This is The Core.
What to
do? Guys, I didn't just hear that. All right, guys, so right now we're moving on.
I'm joking.
Right.
So now we're moving to the cookie jar segment.
That's the evil guy.
We need to blow him in.
I didn't do anything. You need to what?
Nothing.
Great.
Okay, well, did I just grunt? Oh my goodness, guys, just permit that. That was just... But moving on, we're moving to the cookie jar segment. Right. Tinto only has to dip his hands into that. Bring up a paper, read the question out, and if you can't provide an answer...
Well,
we have a timing to it, so as many as you can take. But as you take one, you eat the cookie, you're already picking another one. So no time, man.
No time.
I can help you hold that.
The time is counting right now, man.
So, yep.
Cookie jar segment. Anticipate.
4.9.
So you read out the question out loud,
yeah? Yeah, sure, breast. Yeah, breast now.
Breast. Yeah, please read that. Please read that again.
Hey, yeah, sure, breast.
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 Breast, okay, yeah, that's where it's going from. Okay. So you're going
from... Oh, not breast.
Breast.
That's not breast, too.
No, that breast. Yeah. Breast with the spelling of that breast. Yeah, no, that yash or breast.
You know. Say it the way it's spelled.
Oh, yash or breast.
Breast. So you go for what?
Right, which one
you go for?
Oh, but I don't know.
You gotta pick one.
I'm not gonna do yash, Steve. Not the one where I know.
Okay.
I think I'm
going to pick another one.
Okay, I don't die for you. They don't finish me. Oh, what's your weirdest habit? I don't know. Sometimes I dig my finger in my nose.
Weirdest habit. Weirdest, like weird.
Weirdest. Digging around in your nose is just pretty.
This is dipping around your nose.
No, like dig for gold.
That's disgusting, man.
Yeah, but for me, that's weird. But man, I have to breathe properly. Favorite sex position. Doggy style.
Okay. Y'all heard it.
We didn't see none of that in there.
You didn't tell us that we read this before we went to the house. Have you ever cheated on your wife? No, I haven't.
Oh, that's great.
Ah, see, before I marry, I think I'm. I did tell you.
Right.
Have you ever paid for sex? When I was much younger, yes.
How many times? Can you remember how many times you did
that? No, once. Down and those guys out. Then we were young. I was probably about 21.
Alright.
21.
Not really young, dude, because I know a lot of guys that have done that at the age of 16 or something.
Before.
Actually, I had sex for the first time when I was 17, so...
Oh. Okay. I'm deep, man.
Trust me, when you stay in my area...
KJC people.
Oh, Bob. Top three sex symbol futures. I have no idea, man.
Your top three sex...
symbol features.
I don't know.
You gotta think about something.
You gotta be naive again. Just
no, but I don't know really, because this sex things, I don't think about it all.
You have to throw it in your mouth.
Either one. Take another one. Yeah, take another one. Take another one. TTT.
I'm going to one.
No. Put that out for your mouth now.
Why?
Because she didn't ask the question right.
Why? Why? I don't want.
No. Great. Yeah, pick another one.
No.
Pick another one.
Right. What's the question now?
No,
you have to talk.
You have to talk with that biscuit in your mouth.
Hello.
Yeah.
More people don't know about you.
Okay. Yeah. Did you guys get that?
One thing.
Tell us one thing most people don't know about you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. One thing.
Answer the question before you give me paper now.
I can keep a secret for a very long time.
No. People know that about you. Yes, yeah. People know that
we're
about
pretty
you.
Secretive in the BB house.
Yes,
so,
you were, so no.
No, so just take
another. No, we don't.
We know that about you. Excuse me. That's not new.
Cookie, please. Cookie.
Two
cookies. Take one, then take another.
Two,
You know, we know you're very secretive.
Are they hungry? Let me be the chop.
Just the chop and they go.
Wait,
no.
What time are they?
What time are they? Where are
you? Yeah, they laugh me.
Yeah, great one. Yeah, another one. Pick the question now.
Oh God, what's
Bob? What language are you speaking, man?
What
did you say?
Hold on,
read
it again.
Were you really attracted to Bisola?
Mm.
Or was it all part of the game?
Mm.
Yeah. I was attracted to Bisola.
You were for real?
Day one.
Yeah?
Not for herself or for her mind. She was. I was already a fan before I met Bisola. I'm going to follow her on Instagram, called her skits. I had whenever I got introduced to Bisola through my wife.
Oh.
I said, come and see the girl that went fast, the bad guy.
Okay.
Because I also want to do short films.
Okay.
And skits that I said, look at her. She also has stuff that she's done before. Oh, okay. So I went like, oh, great.
That's great. All
right, more questions, more questions. Mm. Now we know that. Mm, that's a good one.
Can you touch your tongue? Can you touch your tongue to your nose? No, I can't.
Can you hold up? Say that again.
No, up like, no, I can't.
Okay,
like
great.
You pull.
Another two.
Yeah. No, now, you said to be honest now. It's not like I don't want to do it.
Who says you can't touch your tongue with your nose? Have you tried it before?
I've tried it before.
Have you tried it? Try it again.
Tried.
I can't.
No, you just pull it out.
No, just
put it on your nose.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I can't. I've tried it before.
So, take two cookies.
Again?
Yes, because why won't you be able to put your tongue out of your nose? Everybody.
Okay, show me.
I can't. I have lip on.
Do that later.
Sorry, I have lip off.
All right, guys. So yes, it's eating the cookie.
Yeah.
We go on another break, and cookies are finished. Yes, pass me the cookie there, guys. We'll be right back.
Be right
it's
back.
Oh! Hey.
This is the car.
You just call me a wannabe because I'm an Arsenal fan. We'll trash this out after this. So guys, right now we're moving on to the now and then segment. Basically, we look at the before and the after of our topic. So we're talking dance as a profession.
All right.
Now let's look at dance before the 80s and the 70s.
Before you were even born.
We're not born
probably.
In the
okay.
80s, that kind of thing. So how was dancing then as a profession?
Was it even a profitable profession?
Was it profitable?
It was, you know, in the time.
Financial aspect there.
At least there was a. There's an icon there, Ogunde.
All
right.
What's the full name again?
Right now I can't
remember.
Yeah, but you know, most of us, whenever we call the name, we are because there's a whole lot of stories and histories. Yes, that went with the
about him. Yeah.
Yeah. So about the time when he came up with the national troupe or came up with the people that would dance, like the respect was
awesome.
You had to fight, and even the art councils from the state level, because they will always bring a representative from each state,
right?
Okay.
And then they will make an audition to say, okay, finally this one can be part of the national.
So there was more like a solid body of dancers before.
Yeah, nice idea then. Yeah, and these were not just young people; these were men.
Yeah.
These were married men, fathers, but people who.
Educated.
When they dance,
they forget that they become children.
They strike the floor,
right.
And as in they do it. So we have like people like Mr. Lawrence. He lives in America now, and he would hit the drums like there's no man's business.
Mm.
You know, like they picked every single individual from every part of Nigeria to make the national troupe of Nigeria.
You know,
and it was amazing. Going on tours, traveling. Mm-hmm. You know, they were respected.
I've not heard about them anymore.
Oh my God, they're still there. The National Troupe of Nigeria is still there.
No, from the way he's talking, I can feel like, the aura that
there was a very strong foundation. Mm-hmm. Then do we have that now?
We still do.
Better or worse?
But because now, you know, every direction now has gone in other aspects of the arts and not just dance.
Right.
You know, so. But about that time, these were the people after they even retired from the national troupe, started their own troops, their own foundation.
But it's no longer as solid as it was back.
Well, people are growing every day. That's what I would say. Mm-hmm. And But the amount of people who have gone into dance now, the younger generation who has been or opened up to say, I want to be involved in
dancer,
has been much more.
Okay.
You know, most older people now will not think themselves to be dancers. But about that time,
retired,
it was this same sort of people that even if you came as a young person, they'd be like, the youngest then was a guy called,
and it's probably
Bassi.
And it was probably how
his name was
Bassi. Probably how old then?
He is, he turned, in 2000, he turned 31. He was the
he was the youngest dancer among
but he was the youngest then.
Okay.
So what he did now he's a producer now. So what he did was all that money, like they would there was a whole lot.
They were paying them
cool
cash.
So all that money he had to buy equipment, like he saw what the future was like.
Yeah.
We don't have them being celebrated. You're talking about they had cool cash, but right now probably are not talking about cool cash now for dancers.
That's true.
For dancers.
So so what's your hope or what's Fiend All 20, I was going to call it All 20, but let me still put that in. What's Fiend All 20 going to do to make sure that that cash
starts trooping in, like it was before?
We do have capable people that are holding the Dance Guild of Nigeria together.
Okay.
And my involvement will try as much as I can to be involved in every decision
every
making,
dance,
you know. We know that we have the World Dance Day we're celebrating very soon on the 29th. And there will definitely be a whole lot that I would like to offer.
Right.
Mine will probably be to sit, talk with them and say, okay, what's the plan?
Right.
Because, you know, I've been off radar for 3 months. I'm still trying to catch up. But most of these dates are still things that we celebrate every time. So we'll see what we can. It means to walk with them, go to a place and say, give us funding. Let's try and get lights or stuff. Just celebrate the day.
I mean,
on its own, and then move on from projects to projects.
Yeah. If why don't you think? Why I think like if you're gonna make that work, you already have a platform or a blueprint from Ogunde. Why don't you just go back?
Yeah.
Let them see how things were before, and just make it.
Well, you know, right now with the national troop.
We're just going to hold that thought. We need to
go on a break. We're holding the thought.
All right, guys. So we have to go on a break, and when we return, we'll have more questions. But there's a particular question
Definitely.
I want to ask you. It's coming very, very hard. So, guys, we'll go on a break, and when we return, the call continues.
This is The Core.
Want to know who Thin Tall Tony is crushing
on right now?
Your man crush and then your woman crush.
When you say man crush, I hope this thing doesn't have 14 years.
No, it doesn't trust me.
Right.
You're straight, so you're safe.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, before you hear the things, somebody can say,
you
mentioned my name.
Yes, sir.
You'll be like, not sure.
Not sure. Okay, so take it away.
Man crush.
Yeah,
it have to be Nigerian.
No, it doesn't have to be Nigerian.
Oh, then the man crush is Brad Pitt.
Why is he your man crush?
Brad Pitt's your man crush.
He's an amazing person. You know.
Have you met him in person?
I've spoken to him once on Twitter.
Oh,
really?
You know, but he's just great. You know, he's that person that. Because most time when I go on stage or even myself, I like to switch looks.
Okay.
Most people say I look like Conor Farrell. I've not really seen that much that he's done like that. But I love Conor Farrell as well. But Brad Pitt, it's a whole lot that he's
done.
Because
of the fact that he loves to change looks and you love to change
looks.
Yeah,
you know.
Because he's cute.
And then characters and all of that.
Brad Pitt,
cute. Yes.
Okay.
You can appreciate your fellow man now, you know.
I'm appreciating.
Do you think Brad Pitt is cute?
I think he's a very handsome dude. No, I don't. I know he's a very handsome dude. I'm not thinking that. He's a very handsome.
She's
dude.
She's the word cute. I'm trying to get.
Yeah, like cute, like a dog or a puppy.
You're not seeing her. Nah, babe, they say guy cute. It's okay.
I'm not saying
that. Like one girl would tell me one time. So Tony, my God, you look at my puppy dog.
Oh my goodness.
Are
cute.
Hey. I said, puppy dog. I'm like, okay, more dog come off for here now. Yeah. Can I really not understand? You don't look me. Don't call me dog.
You call me puppy dog.
They say no, no. You don't
understand. No, I just call you a dog. Say,
in Nigeria, where I come from, that's an insult. You know.
You don't understand. I just, oh my God, can't even take compliments.
So who's your woman crush?
Yeah. Woman crush, Rita Dominic.
Oh. Hi. Okay.
She is. What? She's just phenomenal, man. A few people that I follow. Or just want to get a story to be inspired. She's one of them.
She's
really done really great from being the actor that she is, or rather being the individual into the actor and then into being the director, producer. You know, the growth is there.
Yeah.
And she fine, man.
She fine. I like that fact. You know, she fine. That's emphasized. She fine.
You know, actually, that, yeah, you know.
She fine.
Because when I did Heartbeat the musical,
yeah.
She came to watch.
Okay.
So I went downstairs as a fan. Yeah. I just wanted to go and say, oh, auntie, thank you for coming to see the thing. The next thing she goes like, my God, I'm a fan.
Oh.
I followed you from when you started dancing and seeing you on stage acting. It was just great seeing me. From a man, I say, in if it was, who I be?
Who I be?
Now I thought that's strange. You know it's it. What? Snap, Bishop.
That's cool stuff. All right, man.
So yeah, the segment actually called The
Verses.
Yes, yeah, so you know, you understand.
So in the Bible, the verses is not enough.
No, not enough.
You need more.
That's verses.
Oh,
verses.
Oh, like punch fight.
That's how English can be a bit twisted.
So we're pitching, I'm pitching T-Boss and Bisola.
Okay.
So if you were supposed to pick between the two, who would you go for?
And who would you kick out?
Analyze everything about them, beauty, brains, intelligence, whatever.
Okay, so who I would pick between...
Who are you going to pick between T-Boss and Bisola?
Who I will not pick.
Who would you pick?
Oh, definitely. I'll ditch T-Boss. I pick Bisola.
All right. What are your reasons?
T-Boss.
Why?
Ditching
because,
T-Boss.
Because T-Boss didn't give you the green light when you.
No. It's not even that. Funny enough,
with all
the times that we've been in the house,
yeah,
we've been able to relate with every housemate.
Mm.
If you want to talk about T-Boss,
yeah,
T-Boss is an amazing person.
Okay.
But why I would pick Bisola over T-Boss is Bisola is also in the same line as me, like a creative person.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I had that moment to ask every housemate, you know, after now,
right,
what do you like to do?
What do you want to do?
Mm. Because you have to also see a possibility of not just being the island. Mm-hmm. You must be able to look for that way, you know, you can collaborate in the future.
Right.
And Bisola was the only person that said stuff that
resonated with you.
In relationship with what I want to do. Apart from that, like I said, she does short films. I want to learn that from her.
Okay.
She's very good. If at all, she will not be able to, you know, give me a few pointers. She can point me in the right direction to say, okay, where I learned from, go there. Because it's all about where people learn from that they take out and show.
Yeah.
So you can always give reference back and say, if you want to do stuff, these people are good, these people are not. I worked on the radio for 5 months before I went into the house.
Okay.
But I found out that even while she worked in radio as well. So, and she's very articulate and, you know, the ways that she comes out, she's a very strong character.
Mm-hmm.
I want to also learn that you can't have everything.
That's a lot. I like the fact you've been honest about likeness for Bisola.
Now, when the finale, when we were watching it, then you saw your wedding band.
Yeah.
You said it was a game plan or something for you when you went into the house, not to let people know that. Let her know you were.
Wasn't a game plan. I just didn't want to tell anybody that I was married.
Wasn't a game plan. Okay, totally accepted. Now, how did you? She saw the wedding band and said, "Oh, I think it was only. I'm just going to. I saw his wedding band and everything.
Yeah.
Did you think that was real? A reaction towards it. And then I know you guys saw yesterday. Has that been sorted out? Are you guys cool at the moment?
For the moment she saw the band and I saw her. I saw her reaction because you know by the time I left the game and the doors opened and closed, I stopped playing. I'm not playing the game anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So I've gone back being
being yourself.
No, I was always myself.
All right.
I was always myself in the house.
You have to correct me. No, it's true.
I was always myself in the house, but I was not the married guy.
Okay.
I was just Tony. The only thing I wanted to show was to tell people I'm a creative guy. Yeah. I do a whole lot of things.
A lot of things,
You know, and like I said, to change the...
Back to the back.
Yeah, you know, So back to the question,
Back to Bisola. I believe that was honest because... Whether we like it or not, you can't form for You can't phone for camera.
Right. Oh, you can't. No, you can't. Character-wise?
No, you can't.
She's an actress. Don't forget she's an actress. You know.
No, you leave the actor-actress thing. All right. Okay, do you want to tell me that as soon as FA1, all that jumping for joy was acting?
No, that's different kind of joy.
No, it's the same thing, you know, because the good part about the reality show is they catch you unawares. Mm-hmm. They just throw stuff at you.
Right.
They show you straight.
All up in your faces.
And when we were in the hall, we were watching, they showed her she was, and then they popped it on.
Right.
It was enough for you to go. You must always have that 2, 3, 4 seconds to freeze, to go what is this? Then you know want to go back into it,
yeah.
Whether I like it or not, every actor.
So you guys are good, so you guys now. Cool. You guys are, you know.
We are very good.
Yeah. I don't know. Sorry, I sort of don't believe you.
No, but yeah, it's true. We are very good.
No, but do you guys talk about it? Like, okay, this is it.
No, for now, myself and Bisola, we have not spoken.
Spoken. All right. So we definitely anticipate when they speak.
No.
We want to know the juicy details that come out of it. So yes, so we want to know. We want to know. Are you guys going to be cool? Are we expecting?
Definitely. Vegas, you know, yesterday they asked her the same question. How far have you talked to Tony about it?
Right.
And she go like, no, there's no need, because it was a game. TV it off. We don't come back
shout
to you.
Shout out, that's maturity.
That's exactly.
Thank you, Tony. We'd like to thank you.
Yeah.
On and on, we kick our guest off the set, but we cannot carry you because both of us joined together. We cannot reach your eye.
We can't reach your eye.
So
man,
we have to beg you to leave.
You know, it's wrong.
Yes.
Yeah, so because of the fact, I feel bad.
Walk of shame. This is the walk of shame.
No, you know,
taking my time. Walk of shame
for being really.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Boys and girls.
I have been on the core.
Right.
I'm about to get kicked out.
Yep.
Get
in a very nice, flexible way. I'm leaving.
All by yourself.
And I'm leaving with the core.
No way.
Okay, I can't.
You can't live with the core. That's what we call the security. Security. It's gonna live with the pill.
Security. Check my wallet.
Thanks for coming, man.
Thank you so much for coming. We
had fun. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, boss.
Oh my goodness! What the? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is The Core.
All right, guys, I hope you had fun today's episode of The Core. Definitely dance as a profession. What?
It couldn't have been any more fun.
I know, right? I mean, fun all the way. Y'all know. Deal with it if you had too much fun. There's never anything called too much fun, by the way.
No, I think the only time is when you die from laughing.
Yeah, but yeah, if you die from laughing, I mean, you have a good death.
Yeah, that's good. I think we sort of balanced up, right?
Yeah.
It makes sense.
I hope people don't come for our heads, though, by saying that.
Come for our heads. Anyway. Don't do that, guys.
Don't do that.
Come for our heads, man.
Yeah, don't come for our heads.
So,
definitely.
Dance as a profession.
Fay Dakel Tony definitely inspired and enlightened us on dance as a profession. It's definitely very enlightened and knowledgeable about that.
Yeah, he knows his onions, like we always say. Yeah, he knows his craft properly.
So, guys, you know, that is one episode out of the thousands and millions also going to be ringing along your way. So, y'all anticipate again for another lit, top-notch lit episode of A Call. But, remember to follow
us. That's a soprano going on.
Lit!
Yeah.
Remember to follow us on our social media platforms at DelarueTV _ on Instagram, DelarueLive on Facebook and Twitter, and definitely where else? Snapchat, definitely.
Snapchat, everything. Twitter,
follow me on Instagram at Ayinfe Balogun, Facebook, Twitter at Ayinfe Balogun 11, Snapchat, the boring Snapchat at Ayinfe Balogun.
All right. And, you know, I take it easy and simple. Dakel _Osh on Instagram, and that's it.
All right, guys, y'all have a fantastic, fabulous, interesting
day.
Wonderful day. We're signing out right now. Dab it. Bye, guys.
This is The Core.